Posse Packer Nation, welcome to another episode of Packcast, the podcast where you don't have to be a Packers fan, but it sure does help. I'm your host, Tom. 6:30 in the morning, Schefter. 6:30. People are sleeping. Grassi. And today, as it was just broken by Adam Schefter, the Minnesota Vikings have traded for Yannick Ngakoue. With what cap? So as of this moment, the Vikings have given up a 2021 second-round pick and a conditional fifth-round pick to the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, that conditional fifth could go as high as a third. That conditional pick can become a fourth if he becomes a first-ballot Pro Bowler, and it could become a third if he becomes a first-ballot Pro Bowl and the Vikings win a Super Bowl. So basically, it's not going to become a third. Now, Ngakoue has gotten a lot of tweets, obviously, after going after Jacksonville's management. He was the only player to not sign his franchise tag tender this offseason because Ngakoue was not happy and made it very, very clear he wanted to get the hell out of Jacksonville. If he was to play on his franchise tag tender this year, it would be $17.88 million. And so what has to happen right now is he has to sign his tender first. He has to play this year on his tender, and then the Vikings could potentially sign him to a long-term deal. But what's most likely going to happen as of right this second is sources are saying that Ngakoue is willing to work with the Vikings to lower that $17.88 million to about 12 or 13 to make cap room, because right now the Minnesota Vikings literally have no cap room. They, on Dante's Inferno scale right now, they are around the sixth circle of hell when it comes to their cap space. Now, I will say though that they are getting a damn good player. He's only missed one game in his four-year career, and he's only 25 years old. In his 4 years, he has 37 and a half sacks, 14 forced fumbles, two interceptions, and 105 solo tackles. He was a Pro Bowler in 2017. And this was an awesome stat coming from ESPN. So since 2016, he is responsible for 5 of the 12 defensive touchdowns. So he had one pick six, one fumble recovery for a touchdown, and he forced 3 fumbles that were recovered by other players who returned them for a touchdown. So yeah, he's pretty good. So questions started forming after this trade already, saying, okay, well, this could mean a few things. One, this could be the fact that they missed out on Everson Griffin and bringing him back because he signed with the Cowboys, right? So they lose a defensive end who's been really consistent for them, so they bring in a playmaker at defensive end. Two, Danielle Hunter has missed 10 consecutive practices, and Zimmer is not giving out any information on why he's injured. The only information he has given is that it's a little tweak, and when reporters are like, people usually don't miss that many practices for a little tweak, he goes, well, you'll see when the injury report comes out. So there is speculation that Hunter might miss some time, which would be a devastating blow for the Minnesota Vikings. Or three, there's going to have to be a lot of restructuring, potential cuts coming down the line, or even more potential trades. Because the Vikings only have a certain amount of money, and right now, it's not much. So there's been talks about potentially making some cuts, maybe their left tackle, maybe Anthony Barr goes away. And this also brings up question about what the hell happens with Dalvin Cook, right? They could theoretically restructure his deal, and maybe the first few years are going to be a team-friendly deal, so maybe it could actually alleviate some cap hellness. But in all sincerity, it most likely means that Dalvin Cook is not going to be with the Minnesota Vikings next year unless there is a drastic restructure of his contract. Taking a look at the Jacksonville Jaguars now, who are just really committing to the tank at this point. They have 8 picks in the first 5 rounds in 2021. So yeah, they're just going to be like, you know what? You can't have players complain about the team if they're brand new. So this definitely makes the Minnesota Vikings a better team. Their defense, which has a lot of inexperience, especially on that secondary, a lot of young guys, bringing in a veteran on the defensive line. And on top of that, with a good pass rush, right, as we've talked about on this show with the Green Bay Packers, it makes your secondary look even better if you're constantly able to get to the quarterback, and whether that is to rush them, force them to make throws, etc. So yeah, this makes the Vikings a better team. Depending on what is going on with Hunter, though, if Hunter is missing a significant amount of time, you know, that is going to be a devastating blow for them. But the pair of these two together with Ngakoue and Hunter, yeah, that is a formidable matchup for the Green Bay Packers offensive line. So in the short term, right this second, it looks like the Vikings have made some improvements. Long term, who knows what kind of deal he is going to wind up signing. I would imagine that there wasn't going to be a trade happening if Ngakoue wasn't going to get a long-term deal from the Vikings. I just don't know physically how they're going to make that happen because they have no money. We've talked about the Chiefs, how, you know, they're making deals and they're plucking out money bags from the money tree. But here in this case, like, the Vikings had no money to begin with, and they're not going to have money for the foreseeable future. And the cap is going to take a hit next year in 2021. Yeah, I would imagine that either by the start of this season or by the end of this season, there's going to be some major Vikings that are going to be shipped down the road, and they are not going to be returning. So on that note, I'm all for this trade if it makes the Vikings continue to suffer in cap hell in perpetuity. I am all for that. But yeah, this is just going to make our offensive line work just a bit harder. But let me know what you think down in the comments below about this trade. Are you shocked? Are you awed? Let me know. You can always find me at TomGrassiComedy.com or at TomGrassiComedy on all social media. See down below. Check out podcasts on SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play Music, Spotify, and of course YouTube. And a big shout and thank you to all the patrons over at Patreon.com/TomGrassiComedy and the YouTube members. Also, a quick reminder. If you have PackCast merch and you want to send in a picture or a video, a short video of congratulations to be featured in the 100K video, send that in because we are 800 subscribers away from that. So send it to grassiposse@gmail.com. But thank you so much for watching. I'm Tom Grassi. And as always, go Pack Go.